congratulations on the launch of the book. And, you know, I think that picture really spurred a lot of people's imaginations, and you ended up writing a book. People ended up writing film scripts, and I've been part of the film, which is the reason I'm here today. It's an amalgamation. I think Jagan Shakti, the director, spoke to about 30-40 scientists there. And then I think they just decided to fictionalize the lives of these women, because obviously they didn't want to. You know, it's about the mission. Yeah. The personal lives were, you know, I think are sacred, which they didn't want to get into. So which is why they fictionalized it. And maybe there are, just so happens, maybe these things are things that, you know, she shared. Or, you know, different scientists must have shared different things that inspired him to put it into the script. But none of us was told to follow a particular scientist. I don't think it was really intended to make science popular, but the reason behind simplifying the science was so that, you know, people who weren't familiar with scientific concepts or, you know, technical terms would also get it. And then maybe we were hoping that kids would go and watch it, and that kids would. And it's amazing, Minnie, that there are so many people who are reaching out to me and saying, you know, my kids watched the film and they loved it. And I've got voice messages from kids. I've got pictures of kids. There was one kid who made a rocket with a Lego, with Lego blocks. There was another who made just a rocket model with cardboard, you know. And then there are these, my nephew said to me, he said, I want to be an astronaut or a space scientist. And I was surprised because he's always wanted to be a cricketer or a musician. So it's a complete, you know, the power of the movies, it's just amazing. I don't know how long it will last, but at least they think that science is not cool.
Yes.
I think that's what happens with watching a film.